Now the next question is, if the lines root 3y minus x equals to 3 and x equal to 2 are tangents to these ellipse, we need to find eccentricity and length of latus rectum and area of this ellipse. So we know that the line x equals to 2 can be tangent to this ellipse only when the value of a is 2. So that means this ellipse, it passes through 2, 0. So we can say that value of a is simply 2. Now for this other tangent, we can write this equation as y equals 1 upon root 3x plus root 3. Now in this case, value of m is 1 by root 3. Value of c is root 3. Now condition of tangency is c square equals a square m square plus b square. Now c square is 3, a square it is 4, and m square is 1 by 3. So it will be 4 by 3 plus b square. So from here we will write b square as 9 minus 4. So it will be simply 5 by 3. So now we have a and we also have b. So we can write eccentricity of this ellipse. So eccentricity is b square equals a square into 1 minus e square. Now b square in this case is 5 by 3. A square is 4 and it will be 1 minus e square. So we can write this as e square equals 1 minus 5 by 12. So it will be 12 minus 5, 7. So it will be 7 by 12. So eccentricity of this ellipse will be under root of 7 by 12, which is under root 7 upon 2 root 3. And that's your option number A. We can also write area of this ellipse. So we know that area of ellipse is pi AB. So we have pi, and then what's the value of A? A is 2. And what's the value of B? B is under root of 5 by 3. So area of this ellipse is 2 pi under root 5 by 3, and that's your option D. And finally, we need to find length of latus rectum. Length of latus rectum is 2 B square upon A. So it'll be 2. And now what's B square? B square is 5 by 3, value of A is again 2. So length of latus rectum is 5 by 3, and that's your option number C. So for this question, options A, C and D, they are correct.